Now, let's assume you are given something like this. How do you prefer a solution to it? Now, this can only be solved using integration by partial fraction. You have the integral 2x minus 1 bracket s square minus 8s plus 15. Now, the first thing you do is resolve this into partial fraction. How do you resolve 2x minus 1 all over s square minus 8s plus 15 into partial fraction? Now, what we are going to do is, first of all, factorize what is under here. If you factorize this, it's going to give us s square minus 8s plus 15. What are those two values? Now, when you add them, they will give us minus 8s, and when you multiply them, they will give us, first of all, let's say the sum is minus 8s. The product of a and c is this s squared times 15s, which is 15s squared. So what are those two numbers? Now, when you add them, they will give us minus 8s, and when you multiply them, they will give us 15s squared. Those two numbers are minus 3x and minus 5x. Okay, minus 3s and minus 5s. So therefore, if you simplify this into partial fraction, into factorize this, become s squared minus 3s, then minus 5s plus 15. And this becomes s bracket s minus 3. Then we have minus 5 bracket. Minus 5 times this is to give us s minus 3. So this gives us s minus 5 bracket s minus 3. And these are our factors. So we come here and say this is 2s minus 1 bracket what? S minus 5 bracket s minus 3. Now, resolving this into partial fraction, you have 2s minus 1 bracket s minus 5 bracket s minus 3 is equal to a all over. You write this again, s minus 5 plus what? B all over s minus 3. At this point in time, you find the LCM of this, which is still the same thing as what? S minus 5 bracket s minus 3. Now, this is all over. When this divide this, is going to give us s minus 3 times a plus, when this divide this, is going to give us b bracket s minus 5. Everything is equal to what we have here, 2s minus 1 divided by s minus 5 bracket s minus 3. Now, this can cancel this. So what are we left with? We are left with 2x minus 1 is equal to a bracket s minus 3 plus b bracket what? S minus 5. Now, whenever you have something like this, you can easily get the value of a and b. Our aim is to get in the value of a and b. Now, when you look at that equation, how can you get the value of a and b? Now, we know that 2x minus 1 is equal to a bracket s minus 3 plus b bracket s minus 5. So therefore, if we say let's equate s minus 5 to be equal to 0, we would be able to eliminate b so we can get a. So to do that, we say let the value of the coefficient of b, which is s minus 5, be equal to 0. So s will be, this crosses to this side, becomes what? 5. So wherever you see s, put 5 in this equation. So this gives us 2 bracket 5 minus 1 is equal to a bracket 5 minus 3 plus b bracket 5 minus 5. 2 times 5 is what? 10 minus 1 is equals to a. 5 minus 3 is what? 2 plus b bracket 0. And this 9 is 2a. Divide both sides by 2. Your a is 9 over 2. Okay? So your a is equals to 9 over 2. Now, have we gotten a as 9 over 2? What will be the next thing for us to do is to calculate the value of b now, to get in the value of b. Now, notice something first before we write out. Note that our integral is a over s minus 5, or the partial fraction is a over s minus 5 bracket s minus 3. So we'll not make mistakes later. Now let's look for the value of b. How do we look for the value of b? Now we can look for the value of b simply by making the coefficient of a to be equal to 0, so we can eliminate a. Make everything in a there to be what? Equal to 0, so we can easily eliminate a. And that will be, you have, where's the value of a? S minus 3 be equal to 0. So when this crosses to this side, become s is equal to 3. So in this equation of 2s minus 1, a bracket s minus 3, then plus b bracket s minus 3, or s minus 5 rather, substitute in s is equal to 3. So this becomes 2 bracket 3 minus 1 is a bracket 3 minus 3 plus b bracket 3 minus 5. 2 times 3 is 6 minus 1 is a bracket 3 minus 3 is 0 plus b bracket 3 minus 5 is what? Minus 2. So 6 minus 1 is 5 is equal to, this gives us 0 plus bracket minus 2b. Plus times minus is minus, and 5 is what? Minus 2b. So to find b, divide both sides by minus 2, and then our b is minus 5 over 2. So we've gotten our a and we've gotten our b. How do we now prefer solution to the partial fraction, or the integration on the integral of that partial fraction? Now, expressing it in the partial fraction to start with, you agree with me that our 2x minus 1 all over s minus 8s plus 15 is now equal to a all over s minus 5 plus b all over s minus 3. Now, what is our value for a? You can remember that we solved our a and it gave us 9 over 2. Okay, our a was 9 over 2 and our b is minus 5 over 2. So wherever we see a, we put 9 over 2. Wherever we see b, we put minus 5 over 2. So this gives us 9 over 2 divided by s minus 5 plus minus 5 over 2 divided by s minus 3. Okay, so at the end of the day, what are we going to have? Plus times minus is minus. This 9, these 2 will come down. So this gives us 9 divided by 2 bracket s minus 5. Okay, or we can decide to say, let's leave it like this. This becomes 9 over 2 plus this times this is what? Minus 5 over 2, then s minus 3. Now at this point in time, we cannot find the integral of this, because this here, which is the question given to us, is still this in partial fraction. Now to find the integral, what we do is take all the constants out, okay, or use the integral to multiply through. So this gives us the integral of 9 over 2 raised to the power of s minus 5 minus, let's say, the s first, minus the integral of 5 over 2 all over s minus 3 ds. So this is a long one. It's a very long one. Okay, at the end of the day, what are we going to have? You're going to have, let's do that quickly, that we know that we are done with this question. It's taking us almost 10 minutes to solve just one question. Must be a very long one. So what are we going to have? We take the constants out. The constants are what? 9 over 2. So if we take 9 over 2 out, what will be left here? 1 all over s minus 5. Then the s minus, if we take the other one, 5 over 2 out. So we have integral of 1 all over s minus 3 ds. Now, at this point in time, what do we do? We know that this 9 over 2, when you integrate this, it will give us times the natural logarithm of s minus 5. Because when you integrate 1 over anything, is the natural logarithm of that thing. Then minus 5 over 2, when you integrate this, we say when you integrate 1 over anything, is the natural logarithm of that thing. So this becomes the natural logarithm of s over 3, and everything is what? Plus c, and that is the correct answer to this question. So the correct answer is what? 9 over 2 natural logarithm x minus 5 minus 5 over 2 natural logarithm s minus 3 plus c. That is the solution to that question. Now the next question says, integrate this. Integrate sin s cot s ds. Now how do we integrate this? We can say, let u be equals to cot s. Now if u is cot s, what will this give to us? Du ds will be what? Differentiate u with respect to s to give us what? Sin s. Okay, so our du will be sin s ds. Ds to be sin s ds. Now note that this equation sin s cos s ds can also be written as cot s sin s ds. Okay, can also be written as cot s sin s ds. And notice that we already made the substitution for what? Sin s sin h or sin s ds. So in place of sin s dh, we can put what? We can put du. But note also that we said let u be equals to cot s. So in place of this cot s, we can put in u. So this becomes u times sin x dx. Now our sin s ds is what? Du. From this substitution we made here, it's du. So this gives us u times what? Du. Now u du means what? Differentiate u with respect to u. And if you have to integrate this rather, this becomes u 1 plus 1 divided by 1 plus 1 plus c. This becomes u square all over 2 plus c. Now u square is what? What is our u to start with? U is cot s. So we have cot s square plus c all over 2, which we can say is cot square s all over 2 plus c, or we can say is half cot square s plus c. And that is the solution to that question. Let's take the next question quickly.